like the dash?
No, Nasus is Q.
Oh yeah, I know that, but I didn't know what Tur was doing.
He was just auto attacking her to death.
Basically, just queuing her. Yeah.
But I was like, I don't know what's happening, and I start.
What is Emily doing? Why isn't he doing anything? Why is he dying?
Oh well, they won. Who cares?
I mean, it's not about who wins or not.
Wait, is the fish sticks and custard guy in the Skype call right now?
He is, but he doesn't have a mic.
Okay.
Hey, Jovial, what do I call you?
Yeah, what's your name?
John.
John? Okay, John. My name is Terry.
Nice to meet you.
His name is Terry. I talk shit a lot.
Yeah. Honestly, I don't know the skill names. I don't really pay attention to them. So I could probably figure out what plans they have, what the hell they're trying to do.
Okay.
Instead of saying, nothing's happening.
And you call yourself a diamond?
I don't know, I mean, hey, I play for fun.
Talk shit about Terry.
Yeah, this is not for tryouts. This is talk shit about Terry commentary.
No. I understand. I already don't like Terry.
don't go with the flow. Okay?
Do not go with the flow. But Terry doesn't love me.
Terry,
you guys don't even know me.
Terry doesn't love me. I said hi to Terry. I was like, Terry, I like your IGN. Remember the first time I talked to you?
Yeah, I really wanted to play.
Same, I want to play.
I did, but then there's already too many people. So I think they're doing another game with the same people.
Just to make sure.
No, they're doing it because they want to try out the people for Division 1, like Diamond 3 Plus, Diamond 1, whatever.
That was a misleading Facebook post then.
Well,
yeah, no, I felt that, like, it was, there were way too many people, and people, like, they kept, like, filling out the forms, like, like kind of late. So it was really hard to organize everything, because I felt like if we had a deadline for the form fill out, for, like, the first day, they can put out the roster for the first game, so people didn't have to wait. Mm-hmm. But there were way too many people just signing up. So it was just
maybe
really chaos.
Next time you do it on, like, a first come, first serve basis would make more sense.
No, it's because this is, because we had our meeting yesterday, and then we decided yesterday that we should have tryouts this weekend because Monday and Tuesday people don't have school, so it's a great like time to try out. And then we're gonna have.
Where's Timmy?
Just I have one quick question. What is Philip trying to say in these Skype messages?
I
think he's saying there's too many people, and then he has to type everything.
Right, but he's trying to
communicate with us.
I prostrate myself in apologies. Okay, I was just...
I don't know what that means either.
I'm trying to understand.
No, but there will be more tryouts.
Yeah.
Because then we...
Yo, can I still participate even if I'm not full-time? Because I looked at the form, and then if you're not a full-time student, you can't play. And then let's say I just bullshitted my way through.
I don't know.
Supposedly, I played. I don't want to, like, you know, be disqualified.
I don't know. I'm just a secretary. I don't do the.
Yeah.
It's not just the tournaments. I mean, like, are we only doing CSL this?
No, there's other tournaments there. That's why.
Yeah, there are other tournaments, and we can totally like just join other tournaments as well. Like, it doesn't just have to.
And it doesn't have to be the big one. It doesn't have to be the tournaments that we pick. If you find like a really cool tournament and say, and you want to join it, you can like tell the whole club, look, hey, I found this really cool tournament. I think we should try it out, and then consider it.
Cool tournament won't be really publicized.
Tournament, I found it.
And like, we can
actually, I think there's like a online tournament. I think they do it monthly. I forgot the name of the website though.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. I think I know what you're talking about.
I think one of you guys posted it up last time I checked.
Yeah, I posted it up.
Yeah,
I'm sure I did.
Yeah,
it was like every week. It's like you just like sign up and every week they have.
Are we like 3 minute delayed?
Yeah.
You have to spectate. You don't comment on the stream, spectate one of the
games. Almost gonna come on a stream.
Wait, I'm not. How can I spectate this video game?
This video game?
How do
just
I spectate
like,
it?
Just right click spectate.
I'm not in the queue.
No. If you, on the chat, like the brute chat, you could right click spectate, right?
Yeah.
Your first prank.
What the fuck are you talking about? Hold on.
Okay, never mind, you can't do that. I thought you could do that.
No, you can't do that.
Well, if you're friends with Phil, you can spectate it.
Wait, so if I speak now, will they be synchronized?
Yes, right now, yeah.
The people that are watching the stream?
Yes. But there's a delay on the stream.
Oh, hey, you can hear me.
Okay.
Okay, I'll add Phil.
Okay, they banned Anivia and Victor. I know Mingu plays that two main champion.
He plays Victor?
Hey, yep. He's been playing Victor a lot lately.
Add me as a friend so I can spectate also.
And Daniel was actually pretty good, Annie, last game.
Yeah.
Okay, they banned Criminalist, Fiora. Yeah.
But you know, he has a very big champion pool.
And Ahri. Who plays Ahri in their team?
Okay, I'll spectate afterwards.
Ahri?
I'm not seeing this.
No, because he's in the room.
Oh, Ivan, get the hell out. Ivan, get out. Ivan, I see you. Get out.
Wait, I have my list of notes.
Yeah, you could just kick him and call this person.
They ban Brown. Maybe they're going for Danny's main champ.
Everyone is dying. Plays Ahri. It's one of his top champions.
Who?
Everyone is dying is the jungler though, I think. Well,
right, but they banned Ahri because, or if they knew him, then it's because it's one of his top ranked champions.
What about Braum?
Why are you saying this?
Braum, let's see who's on their team. Xaber is good at Braum if he is not playing, but they banned it on his team, so it doesn't matter.
Oh my god!
No shout out to Terry.
Hello?
No.
Hello? Can you shout out to Jam Poop? Hello?
Hi, Terry. I'm single too.
Sorry, guys. I'm sure you guys could find a good man for yourself.
Whoa! He just rejected you.
Haha. Oh, Kalista. On Ivan. Amigos, actually.
Huh?
Yes, amigos.
Kalista and Ivan. Shivana Jungle.
Wait, are like all five of you, are all five of us fucking casting at the same time?
I'm gonna...
No!
Nah.
I'm watching on Phil's stream.
You're watching on Phil's stream? I'm not... Why am I leaving?
I hate Phil, but I just said
I quit.
Me. I just said me, not
I
that.
Quit. No, I don't care. I hate you.
Oh man, a lot of people left.
Yeah, probably because they're gonna watch the exact same match again, that's why.
I love Shyvana Jungle. And Ivan's on Kalista.
Nice.
Maybe an Irelia top? I smell Irelia.
Why?
Oh snap, my phone died.
How would you rate our casting from one?
Wow. It's going mid in their team. Maybe they're swapping.
Maybe do some crazy ass Kha'Zix mid stuff from back in season 2.
Oh, that's my Ori!
Zix.
That's not your Ori.
That's my Ori. That's my best champ.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Jan.
Oh, I think Mingo's going for AP Ezreal mid.
AP Ezreal?
Yeah. Oh. Okay, AP Cog Modus.
AP Cog?
Oh, he's playing again. I mean, he wasn't doing that bad, except he, like, died.
He got caught out a lot. He overextended was the main issue. It was... he was pushing without the support of his team.
This is the first game they're playing together, right?
This is their second game.
This is the second game?
Yeah.
Like, if the Kog'Maw was doing a lot of damage and racking a lot of kills, so if he just stays with, like, a Gnar standing in front of him, he should be borderline untouchable.
Well, they didn't have a Gnar last game.
Shout out to Daphne, because she's the best. Yeah, yes. Ooh, someone transferred to Baruch from Carnegie Mellon.
Where are you getting all this info?
In the Baruch chat.
Oh, I left the Baruch chat.
Why would you leave the...
Well, I think I was closing down all
the... Wait, they transferred to Baruch?
Because of the money.
Welcome back.
Carnegie is good. I know someone who goes to Carnegie Mellon.
Oh, same. He's a nerd.
Okay. Yeah, I know a lot of people who transfer from good, better, like, recognized colleges because of money. My friend told me recently Baruch's requirements went up like crazy. Is that true?
Yeah, they cut. They cut the acceptance rate really low for Baruch.
Wow.
Wait, they made the acceptance, like, the score really low?
Yeah.
No, it's stricter for Baruch. They said, like, they decreased the chances of you getting in for the freshmen this year.
Really?
Wow. Yeah.
Wow. It was like
it went from 1-4 to, like, 1-5 or 1-6 or something.
Okay. I don't know. I remember someone saying that the acceptance rate for NYU was higher than for Baruch. It's just that it costed too much
money.
So, yeah. So that's why, like, even though they were accepting so many people, nobody was really choosing NYU.
Because it stands for now you're unemployed, because everyone just goes there for their fucking stupid-ass film school or something.
For NYU? Yeah, but there's also a lot of rich people who go there.
It's more for, like, the name, for the diploma. You're paying $50,000 for the name.
Yeah,
on a piece of paper.
It's for a brand name.
I mean, it's still a really good school, too.
Mm-hmm.
Baruch sucks. Why do people go here?
So who is Nafucker?
Nah. Who's higher ranked?
I don't...
Who's what?
Me. I don't know. Actually, I don't know. Whoa!
Also,
did Phil just use your nudes? Report.
Damn!
Phil, I can give you a microphone if you want one.
Oh, Phil. Did you hear that, Phil?
Same.
Alright, Phil just commented. He said, I don't need your pity.
I mean, I understand if you're living in, like, abject poverty,
but... No, Phil said he's getting his
mic tomorrow. No, he just made a... He just bought, like, a new
computer. He's coming. It's the mic is coming tomorrow.
He has a nice computer now.
Yo, what's happening, yo?
Oh my god.
Can we kick Ivan? Kick Ivan.
What do you mean?
Now.
Isn't it playing?
You're playing.
No,
he's the one
playing. No, we're loading right now because Everly DC'd.
Nice.
Oh.
Yeah. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Bye.
I'm just trying to play some CSGO.
Same. Bye.
Yo. Wait, so what's happening with the other games?
Nothing. Bye.
Yeah, so Timmy's not playing?
No.
Timmy's not playing.
I'm so sick of Daphne shit. Maybe. I'm removing her from the esports group.
I dare you.
He can't, actually.
Whoa, did somebody say Counter-Strike Global Offensive?
What? No, he said he's playing CSGO. Oh snap, we're doing in-houses tonight? Damn, if I weren't going out. Thanks, Grandma. If I wasn't going out tomorrow.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
I should totally try out for Division 3.
Same.
Wait, why are there different divisions? So are there going to be three different teams participating?
There's three different teams, but it's only... There's three divisions because CSL recently just added a Division 3 where they're going to have, like, gold and lower...
Or lower rank to participate in the game?
People who are gold and lower to play. Yeah, like, basically... For CSL, it was just really, really high-ranked people playing.
What
basically, all the challenger teams.
What if there's, like, a person that's, like, challenger playing on a gold account?
But then, like, the incentive... Okay, so the incentive is that the lower-ranked team has a lower prize pool, and then, like, the Division 1 has a bigger prize pool. So why would they play for, like, 100 RP if they could win, like, more?
I see.
I mean, still trying to, like, get, like, the whole community to join and play. Like, there is a challenger playing on a gold team, I mean, that really sucks, but, like, you can't do anything about it.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
But we're trying to get everyone involved. But, yeah.
Also, it's a morally shitty thing to do.
It is a morally shitty thing to do, and we shouldn't do it. And nobody should do it.
Hello, I'm challenger.
I'm pretty sure people are going to do it.
Yeah, oh, most definitely people are going to do it. Just for the friend who's gold, they can get into it.
Yeah.
So are we like casting this seriously, or are we just like dicking around?
You don't have to dick around, but we can cast this.
I think we should. We have about, 24 people watching this. If you guys are watching, so subtract yourself, including me.
Yeah, but there was 30 people watching me and Daphne being retarded.
I was not being retarded.
Yeah.
Excuse you. I was telling my best jokes.
Yeah,
they were okay jokes.
What?
Yeah, this blue side team. I mean, this red side team is really dedicated to the Yasuo combo. Let's just bring that up for a second.
They are.
What?
Like, that's a lot put
they
in.
They have the Shyvana.
Oh, everyone has a Nako.
Mhm.
So if the Yasuo.
Nautilus is ult. Orianna's ult.
Shyvana ult.
Yeah, but Everly's pretty good on Yasuo.
Shyvana ult.
Right, but if they can't organize themselves, then it's going to be an issue. Or if the Yasuo falls behind and they're banking on him to carry, then they're going to be fucked.
I don't see, like, much disengage.
Yeah. There's no one to protect Kog'Maw.
I mean, they have the Gnar and then the Thresh for Peel if they want to, but...
Yeah, but I think Yasuo and then Shyvana, Kalista, and Nautilus, could just, like, go through any time. But let's see how it goes. It's their second game.
Does anyone else see like invisible players? Like
that happens in the beginning.
Okay, I've
you just have to wait for.
Yeah, I feel like the freshman Danny has so much potential.
Oh yeah.
Hello. You never see that about me.
The game has
potential. I'm trying to focus on the players right now.
I am a player.
Not the casters.
Hello. I have a lot of potential too.
Yeah, I mean, of course, you should always have faith in yourself.
No, I know Danny. He's a good guy. He's a good guy.
I love Danny already.
Danny yeah, he probably has a really good personality too. Most support players have a really good personality.
Same.
you cannot say that because
Chan I said most, not everybody.
No. Most support players, the
majority.
Like I don't know. As a support main, I feel like you're more level-headed than say a mid laner or ADC because it's your job to protect everyone. So you're looking at things as a bigger picture. Rather than a carry who will like tunnel vision for a kill rather than protecting themselves.
Yeah, it's because they're all cocky. They're like, I'm a 1v1 hit.
Yeah, but it's hard not to be cocky if you're that good. It's really hard to stay humble.
Yeah, I'm a
so
better
you have to understand that.
When you won me.
Wait. So, are we just using the automatic camera or... Do we all see it the same way? Because I don't want to be talking about something that's not showing up on the stream.
Okay, so the thing is, it's Phil's stream, so it's according to Phil's point of view.
Right, so how do I know what he's looking
at?
So
just focus on like major team fights or like something major that's happening.
Okay.
So we'll try to speak like one person at a time.
Okay.
I guess.
It's on Phil's camera point of view?
Yes.
So I have to watch the stream then.
No, because there's a delay. You can't do that. You're gonna be talking about something that happened 30 seconds ago, like it just
I see.
But what a hype start for this video game. This is what League of Legends is all about.
Okay, so the game's starting. There's a pink from the blue side going to the mid river on the right towards the blue.
Maybe they're gonna feed one kill to tower and then start the game. This is how you let the enemy know you don't fear anything. It's called the stance of ultimate victory.
What?
I actually developed this technique. It's where you get an execution before a minion spawn on the towers, and then you just come back to life and play the game. So the enemy is afraid of you. They know that you're not afraid to die. And so it's all about the Yomi.
Although they're so cute, they're moving together in a group.
Never cross the river. Okay, look at this standoff.
Oh, I think I've seen this before with Sammy.
Sammy is... Yep.
Okay, so... He senses danger and backs down. But he... I don't think he knows they're in that bush.
He doesn't know. Oh.
Oh, but they get spotted by the ward.
No, he sees them. The ward.
Yeah, they know that.
They gotta back up.
But blue side does not know that red side knows.
Minions have spawned. They do know.
They didn't. They saw the ward.
They saw the ward placement too.
They didn't know. They didn't see the red ward in the pixel brush.
Oh yes, they didn't. Yeah.
So they knew ahead of time when they went to transfer over. And
that's called a pixel brush.
The one brush in the river is called a pixel brush.
Wow. How about the towards the Baron side? Is the pixel brush towards the Baron side?
Yeah. The same thing.
No, there's no brush there anymore.
Yes, there is. I'm looking right at it.
Wait, what?
Saying there's no brush in the river by Baron? Are you on?
Yeah. Oh.
Wait, yes, what? And
do you even play this double jump? Do you even play this game?
Wow, Daphne, I just take this
from 10 PM.
Okay. How about we let John talk? I feel like he's a lot more committed and league educated.
Nar going in for the steal, but does not secure it.
Poor Nar.
Is my crunching loud?
No.
It's. It would be. But the stream would be better if it wasn't there. But
I don't hear anything.
Just because you said that, I'm not muting myself. I'm not sorry.
Well, only the best casters at Baruch.
Wait, Danny is a support main?
Yes.
Yes. I believe so.
Yeah, look at his zoning. Oh.
That is some aggressive play by Thresh, but the Wrens will hurt him a lot more. It'll cost him more than the game. Yasuo doing the classic standstill technique.
Oh my god. Why did Sammy change his Twitch name to Samsung Wu too? Was it full today?
Okay.
Let's see. Someone's coming back for a fight. Okay. Flash down from Flash.
And the hook is caught.
Nice. Very nice.
Lantern.
The clutch lantern is fine. Flash down by Siobhan. And the rent.
Nice. Nice peel from Thresh. Okay, summon is down.
Yo, that's like my Shyvana.
Thresh and Lucian accept the exhaust.
There was a lot of summoners burned by red side too, with nothing really gained.
That's my Shyvana.
Only Shyvana's flash was down.
Right. I thought Nautilus flash.
No problem. Ikka's going for engage at top on Yasuo. In Nautilus coming. Double pass. Yasuo might kill. Ooh, nice try. Oh.
He could get
the spike. Ooh, Yasuo. With the cup. Okay, I think it's Yasuo's dead.
Oh no! Ooh. Oh my god.
Oh, well, play from Yasuo. Very well played.
Let your friends die before going in for the kill. That's the Jimmy Q way.
Typical Jimmy Q.
Classic Jimmy Q.
The magic man.
Not even.
Ian? You know what Brother just said? Fuck Magic Man. He literally just said that. He screamed that from the bathroom just now.
Who's Magic Man?
Fucked.
There's a gank mid lane with Shyvana coming in for the Kog'Maw, but he has it warded, so he should be.
I think Kog'Maw's trying to play this out. Fake it. Waste Shyvana's time.
Act like you don't know.
And sorry. Just guessing like nothing's happening.
Stand forward. He should not have done that. But he gets out.
That was fine. Wasted enough time. I think there's a solo kill from Yasuo at top. Okay, I think Kai's gonna go for the pick up.
I actually wanna hear what they sound like when they're playing.
Ooh, caught by the word.
All it sounds like when it's a 5-man team is just Shyvana blue, Shyvana blue, Shyvana blue, Kog'Maw, 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 Kog'Maw,
nah,
nah,
nah, nah, nah,
nah. Nice.
Always level 6 when the solo kill.
Oh, Sammy.
Does not work.
Yeah, flash ult.
Black.
Okay, Ori's dead. Go flash. Nice kill.
Nice. Yeah, so placing a ward in the middle of the river because he suspects Kha'Zix is going to be back again. In the bot lane, CS is just about even.
That's an A-ram.
A hook onto Nautilus, but he doesn't do anything with it, and he gets a whole lot of health lost for it. Junglers are fighting it out in mid lane.
Ooh, that was pretty close.
One for Shyvana.
Yeah,
it's for Jimmy.
It's always risky to fight a Kha'Zix anyway because of his passive, but it worked out in the end because he had the smite advantage on him. And he also had a big wave of minions beating on him.
Okay, Shyvana's going gank for a bot.
By the pink
Flash board. Is still down. Okay, this Thresh is dead. Shyvana. Okay. Ooh! Danny!
The
Danny! I'm telling you, this Thresh has so much potential, yeah.
That is not Danny.
That was Danny. That was all Danny.
That was not Danny.
That was all Danny.
He's willing to sacrifice the support for a jungler is a good trade any day, actually. Because it gives your jungler a lot more pressure on the map.
Okay, Kha going for a gank fight, he's coming around. So he checks the wards are there. Kha'Zix and Nautilus won't back until they get all this CS down. That's just how this goes. If Thresh makes it on time, this could be a really nice thing. I think they're gonna keep the pressure. Going from the back.
Oh, okay.
Kha is going alone.
Slowly walks in, but Lucian's follow up fast enough.
Yeah, they're going for Nautilus.
For the ult. When he cancels the Thresh Lantern.
Yeah, that was a pretty bad focus. Can they get comeback? Things really happen.
Yeah, they did not synchronize that properly.
Okay, this Kog'Maw might be in danger. Orion is beating this. That's going to be a bit. Yeah, back that time.
A hook comes through from Danny to secure kill, I believe.
Okay.
Wait, do you guys like know Mingu personally?
I know Mingu personally. I think Janet's that close too.
I don't know him personally, but I know him. Because he played for our team. He's the godly Anivia.
Yeah, his Anivia is really good.
Everybody's a godly Anivia.
No.
No, I think he plays really, he is really unique Anivia. You have to see him play.
Mm-hmm. How come we don't know Mingu personally?
Me?
We went to PAX with him.
Ooh, Jimmy. Wow, that's an experiment.
He's just gonna steal the dragon like a real motherfucker. Like a genuine motherfucker.
There's so much props for the casters. I don't know how they make it so entertaining.
all jokes. Danny's on top. Oh, nice.
Look at this thing. I'm telling you, I see something. Oh, I think that's just so we can make a comeback. That is Danny's down. Danny's down.
Oh, but
yes. Okay, Danny's down.
Okay. But he should be able to secure something from... Maybe.
Oof.
Excellent flash to dodge the boomerang.
Please.
But that is gonna make him vulnerable to a gank.
Shimano's gonna win this. I take that back! Jimmy!
You can't duel a Kha'Zix that's 4-1. You can't do his passive will make him win every time, and the Shimano's not realizing this.
He went invisible.
Right, and he's gonna do that and win every time. I'm pretty sure. Well, two of the Shimano's three deaths have been to the Kha'Zix.
Okay, I think I'm gonna go sleep. Bye guys!
I can!
Have fun!
Danny.
Oof, Jimmy.
For the reset. Lucian knew and baited them into that. Good map awareness.
Damn, Jimmy is
6-1. So, Orianna, I've noticed, going for the Athenes rather than trying to get the tier as fast as possible. So, not even sure. And then double Doran's ring after that, also. Although, Sarah's Embrace is an extremely powerful item on her, so I'm not sure if she plans on getting that anytime soon, because the sooner you buy it, the faster it stacks. But she decides to go for the Athenes instead. But there's a 10 CS lead in the top lane, also. With Yasuo 2 kills ahead.
But Gnar just 1v1 him. And won.
How come I can't see the dragon timer?
Because dragon is not close to being.
Yeah, it only spawns when it's like a minute or two away.
Ah, I see.
Yasuo is caught out.
This Jimmy's carrying hard. Ooh, there's a fight in mid against Orianna and Kog'Maw. Yeah. For Kog'Maw.
Shyvana knocked him out of the Orianna ult? Did that just happen, or was it at the same time?
I did not see that. It
this Kalista is free farm apart. Having a time of his life.
The culling comes through.
And Thresh hook. Ooh, Danny!
He lands on the Nautilus, but that's not who they wanted.
Danny. Oh, I think they're going for this too.
No, they're
Jimmy is...
Too deep. Okay, they gotta...
But they're just giving away the bot tower without contesting, but they're willing to trade it for the mid lane tower.
Yeah, they're gonna have to back up.
So the Kha'Zix at this point in the game can pretty much 1v1 anyone on their team right now. Except the Nautilus, I'd wager. Yasuo looking for some tussling. But he's gonna back down.
This Yeah, so am I coming back with a Cogmo kill? Nope.
It's a very Cogmo, especially when he has that tier up already. He's just gonna be clearing for days and days. So again, if Orianna does plan to build the Seraph's Embrace, she's gonna be way behind the Cogmo in terms of getting it stacked. Unless she's trying to go for some not standard Orianna build that I'm unaware of. Cogmo. Oh, they're getting ready for this dragon after blue side secured the first one. See, Shyvana's not going in alone this time, so she won't be as low. But this Kha'Zix is still an extreme threat and steals Steadlecrab away from her. How many people are actually watching? 25. Okay, cool. Hello, stream.
I'm back!
Kha'Zix going in? No, but got significant damage. Almost half health with just a simple combo. And an excellent hook from Danny. Shyvana's gonna go in anyway. She goes in too deep and shockwave. Is exactly what Yasuo wants. He's going into the Thresh and the Kog'Maw. But he's gonna get stunned up and back there. Nautilus is peeling as best he can, so they're gonna take what they can and leave him this fight. But one... Oh, Kog'Maw is out of mana. And the Yasuo's going in and Nara's trying to stop him and the Kog'Maw Suicide Bomber gets him.
Oh.
That is an aggressive flash. She almost dies if it wasn't for the Orianna shield. That was a really well fought team fight by Red Side. Almost went terribly wrong, but if Kog'Maw wasn't out of mana, it would have probably gone to the blue side. And they're back around Dragon, and it looks like Blue Side has control of it. Kha'Zix is zoning, but this is a TP with no support from Yasuo. Kha'Zix turns invisible and flashes away. This great peel for him, and the wind wall completely blocks the calling. So that's a critical ult down to this next team fight. A hook into Nautilus, but that's not what they want. Shyvana extremely low. If she dies, then... But then Kha'Zix also equally as low. Looks like he's gonna... Okay, red team gets it, but Kha'Zix pays for his failed smite. He tries to make a hero play, but just dies. Either way, if he died, it was like, oh, whatever, I didn't get it. But if he got it, everyone would have been shitting out of their pants, because it would have been amazing. When Nautilus hook gets Kog'Maw, he's probably gonna get Yasuo. Kog'Maw gets it, and the suicide bomb actually enables a lot for blue team. Orianna fighting for her life, but she's gonna die real soon. She manages to pull out a kill for Gnar, but because Kog'Maw was able to ult everyone in a small group, he was able to get them low enough so that when his passive detonated, he was able to kill or enable kills for a lot of everyone else on his team. Interesting stuff. I don't know if he planned it to come out like that, but it resulted in ace for blue side. Everyone's going back to their respective lanes. This is 2,000 gold lead. 2,400 gold lead for blue team. And they're looking to clear vision for the Baron, which is spawning in 16 seconds. Not a lot of vision over there, but blue side does have better control of it. Kha'Zix just clearing up some vision. And they're grouping in the middle for a red team, but blue is still scattered. It's unclear how they're going to play this fight. Gnar still a ways off farming top lane while everyone else is moving, so if they engage right now, they will have the advantage. But he looks like he's on his way, as Meganar is about to run out, so they're gonna have to stall a little bit if they want to have that tankiness. See, Orianna still no tier on her. It appears she might be going for a Luden's Echo or something else. Or maybe a Deathcap.
Where did Terry go?
I'm still here. John's doing really well, so I'm just gonna watch this game.
Oh, sure, thanks. Alright, there's Siege mid lane, and Red Side is not there to respond. Shyvana caught out, but the massive shockwave. That was really well fought for Orianna. And Kog'Maw getting ulted. Kalista ults. Kha'Zix coming in on the back line to try to assassinate somebody, but he gets caught out. Thresh gets a hook, but no one's there to follow it up. Kog'Maw running for dear life. Thresh also running for dear life. He may be able to escape, but not if Orianna gets up to him first.
Yasuo's there.
He's coming in. He is kill. Can Gnar save him?
No.
He cannot. Now he's running for his life. Now he gets ulted. Oriel's gonna come in for the shockwave. And another team fight that started off bad for Red Side, but then turn into their favor. They're now 3k gold up. And they're sieging mid lane and top lane at the same time. Shyvana is baiting in blue team to use a lot of their resources just to kill her, and then the rest come in for cleaner crew. Not sure if she decided, hey, I'm 0-6, I'll just be a fucking scapegoat for them, or if she's actually just that bad, and everyone else is capitalizing on it, but it is working for them. Because right now the 0-6 Shyvana is not going to do much except just be a meat shield for the rest of their team. And by putting the ball on her, you have a delivery system really well set up for them. That it's almost practically foolproof unless everyone on the enemy team wastes their flash. So their knock-up team comp is working really well with a 4-2 Orianna and a 7-5 Yasuo. Well, they're still giving up a lot of kills. They're gaining more than they're losing, so they are slowly taking the lead of this game. And everyone's just going back to these defensive maneuvers right now, just farming and trying to bait out a fight.
Ooh, Jimmy flashed out of that shockwave.
But the shockwave will be up for Kha'Zix's next flashes, so... And it does cancel. If he tries to jump away, it will cancel out his jump. So that's big. With a QW doing half Kha'Zix's health, I don't think he's going to be the juggernaut he was in the earlier game. He was 6-1, now 8-4. He's beginning to fall off just a little bit. He has no tanky items. Very little tanky items.
Phil said talk about builds or goals and wards.
Yeah, let's see. Red Side has dominant vision control over the Dragon Pit, which is up in 15 seconds. And then everywhere else, it's very lacking, but because I guess... Okay, Kha'Zix is just dead, so that's going to be perfect for this dragon hit. There's going to be almost no contesting it. They're only warding the immediate objectives, which I guess for right now, since they're just looking for picks, is working out for them, and Nautilus is caught out. He's probably going to give up his life for this, and Orianna's running. They managed to trade support for the dragon, and that is their second dragon of the game.
Ooh,
that's a huge shockwave combo. But Shyvana being 0-6 can't do much to follow it up. Where is the team? Yasuo is just at base right now. He recalled after that.
Oh, he's teleporting in behind. I know.
Yasuo teleporting. Maybe not the smartest teleport in the history of League of Legends. But it... Yo, how do you move the chat because it's blocking my, I can't read it because the UI is blocking it.
The what?
Like, I just want to click and drag it.
Let's see...
The what is blocking it?
The character profiles are blocking the chat, but I don't have a top.
Which like, chat?
No, it's blocking the in-game chat. Like, Phil is trying to tell me something and I can't read it because the character's profiles are blocking it.
Just tell Phil to message you.
Yeah, just message me.
Okay.
Phil, type it like, send the message like 5 times so your yeah. your message is all at the top.
Or press enter.
I'll send like 5 messages, Phil.
Yeah, there you go. Okay. I get it, alright. Alright, another team fight breaking out by Baron. Shyvana going extremely low with no team support. It's an 0-8 Shyvana, a third of the kills for blue side. But then again, she's worth less and less gold every time.
Alright, mid tower
dispel. Oh, race going on, a mid for... Red team is definitely going to win this. They do... Blue side has to recall right now or they're going to lose an inhibitor. Kha'Zix is not strong enough to defend all of this alone.
Yep, now you see why there's no Kha'Zix picks on pro games these days.
They're just giving up the inhibitor, they think they can trade it. But, well, maybe they can if Shyvana's the only one coming back. Are they pushing to end? No, they're not, they're gonna back off and just sacrifice inhibitors. Of course, it's always better to have the mid one. Yasuo... killing himself? I don't know, he just tried to die between two towers to get a... try to get a Thresh kill, but it backfired on him. Now happy with this trade, Shyvana running for dear life, gives up another kill.
Someone on stream wrote, bro, you should go shoutcast in Korea, they might teach you how to show emotion.
But Koreans are so mean, like, take Terry for example.
Yo, who's this? No, Booker.
This guy just fucked my life, I don't even have
Koreans
any.
Koreans suck. I'm sure there's a single Korean that sucks dick. I mean there has to be one.
Terry.
I'm not gonna deny it. I mean, gay marriage is legal now. Right? Not Booker?
In Korea?
Not Booker? This is not Booker.
I just,
Pentakill. <Yeah. laughs> Who just, so funny. The Koreans are really good at that.
I'm getting blown the fuck out right now.
Yeah, John, you're doing fine. Ignore the haters.
Oh, these haters, they don't faze me, but they do.
It's alright. Let them hate.
I mean, the Korean shoutcasters go way OD though. They're just like, as soon as this double kill comes out, they go, DOUBLE KILL! DOUBLE KILL! DOUBLE KILL! And then it's just like, relax, and they don't.
Yeah, it's their job.
They are, the Korean shoutcasters are the Spanish commentators for soccer. Like, you know those guys that just go, GOAL! Yeah.
Yo. All I hear are shit talking. What's up with this?
Hello.
Okay, so
shit talk happened at last.
Red team just decimating blue again. Orianna with a double kill, coming out extremely. Yasuo is running rampant.
Bam, bam.
A triple kill. Oh, mom, get the camera.
Yo, you'll see what Sammy does to me, yo. He refuses to shield me.
He refuses to shield you.
Look at it.
I think that's GG.
Okay.
That is GG.
Let me see the Sammy.
Good game, guys.
No, that was.
What was it?
Alright, well, that's the
but
game.
I died.
Red team with a dominant team fight play.
But of course, it would be Sammy.
Man, these guys are coming at my inflection.
Good game, guys.
Very nice.
Yeah, I love these comments from the stream.
Who the fuck is Uncle? Come and fight me right now. I'll give you my address.
Mom, get the camera.
It's Sammy's friend.
Yeah, I love this
apparently.
Right now.
I love you guys.
But Sammy doesn't have any friends.
Right now. 1v1 in Call of Duty.
Call of Duty.
I want to play. I'm getting bored watching all these games.
Alright.
You guys should totally make
watching.
An in-house. Where's Ivan? Is he still here?
Whoever wants to join.
You should just ask like the Brood chat.
Oh, I want to play. Add me.
Oh, no one
who wants to play?
Alright,
John wanted to play.
I wanted to play. Jovial Hot Dog Man.
I think I invited you. Oh, my bad. I invited Hobie. Ooh, my bad.
Yo, what's good? You called?
Yeah.
If you guys want to play, you guys could just type I want to play or whatever in the Brood chat right, and
I'll invite you.
I already made.
Sam, same son, Victor.
Ivan, you want to come?
Yeah.
Hi, your amigos.
Alright, give me invite real quick.
Aye.
Let me show you the true power of
Is Serpentel one of you guys, or no?
It's not me. Did you make this a public game where just anyone can join?
Yep.
Because that might be what that is.
Oh, I'm not playing.
Oh, he's out. He just dipped.
Wait, where are you going, Daphne?
Huh?
Why aren't you playing?
My grandma's kicking me out because she has an interview with the Lawyer Jongsum.
Okay.
And I can't be home.
Yo, tomorrow? I need to learn Chinese.
Wait, I thought we were going to...
I'm going to teach you.
We are. But like earlier than that.
Oh.
I'll teach you an ancient Chinese proverb, okay?
Maybe I'll go to Brooklyn earlier and then we can just go.
Oh, you're going to Brooklyn first?
Maybe.
You gonna be at Kathy's?
Possibly.
Yeah. Sing Hei-sam.
Hei-sam.
Fuck it. I don't wanna play.
Oh, bye bye.
What? You guys? Hey. Now you wanna play?
Let us play video game.
I don't think. Let's see. Just like invite everyone who's there.
Giant wolf.
Wow, Phil, your background is so cute! It's the girl on the violin!
Oh, that's the cutest fuck, dude. No weeaboos allowed. Why don't you just use Notepad? What are you, a fucking caveman? Like... what are you
that
doing?
That is a very lopsided smiley face.
Thank you. Food is more than just a meal. It's the way we care for one another. It's also part of how we take care of the planet. At Monsanto, we believe everyone deserves the love that comes from a balanced meal. And all of us deserve agriculture that provides for a sustainable future. It's time for a bigger discussion about food. Be part of the conversation at discover.monsanto.com.
Think about me when you're all alone. The things we used to do and used to be. I could be the one to make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free. Do you think about me when the crowd is gone? It used to be so easy, you and me.
Asking where we go next. Oh, we're chasing is the sunset. Got my mind on you.
Doesn't matter where we are. Doesn't matter where we are. Doesn't matter, no.
If there's a moment when it's perfect, we'll carve our names as the sun goes down. Hey, as the sun goes down. Hey.
Keep asking where we go next. Oh, we're chasing is the sunset. Come on, mind on you. Doesn't matter where we are. Doesn't matter where we are. Doesn't matter, no. If there's a moment when it's perfect, we'll carve our names as the sun goes down. Sun goes down. Hey.
See you.